Have you been struggling with depression, insomnia, anxiety, or other health issues, and you're looking for a more natural solution? Well, stay tuned, because today's episode, we have joining us Natalie Jurado, magnesium expert, to help demystify magnesium and share her very simple solution. Stay tuned. Welcome to the Heart of an Underdog podcast. We're your hosts, Javi and Jessica, where we talk about how to adapt and overcome your biggest health challenges so you can beat the odds, turn your pain into purpose, and live in victory.
And if you're new to our channel, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you're notified when we post new content.
And if you want to become a sponsor of our channel, be sure to head over to JaviandJessicaMadrigal.com and pick a sponsorship level that works for you. We greatly appreciate your partnership in bringing more valuable content to our audience just like you. Okay, so let's bring out our guest who's joining us today. Natalie Jurado is the founder of Rooted In, a line of therapeutic magnesium-infused moisturizers that actively calm and relax your mood. She is a sought-after thought leader, educator, and speaker, and has worked at the forefront of the wellness industry for 8 years. She's considered an expert in all things magnesium, and her mission is to spread awareness of this powerful mineral to all who struggle to live their most vibrant lives. Magnesium is responsible for over 300 biochemical reactions in the body, including muscle recovery. Deficiency is strongly correlated with symptoms including anxiety, depression, insomnia, chronic headaches, and more. So restoring magnesium levels can be a confusing process, which can leave people overwhelmed and misinformed. So she hopes to demystify this mineral and help people make better health choices as a result. So please help us in welcoming Natalie Jurado to the interview. Hey, Natalie.
Hello. Hello. Thanks so much for having me on today.
Hey, thanks so much for joining us. We are super excited to dive into this
subject. I've been looking forward to this interview because there are so many things, like she said in your bio, that a lot of us, we're so confused about, and we actually just think that's what we have to live with, whether it's insomnia or something chronic like headaches, and I think a lot of times we ignore some of the simple things that we could be doing to our life and adding that to our life to just get rid of those things rather than taking the, you know, prescribed medications or over-the-counter stuff that's really not any good to us.
Right. So can you introduce yourself to our audience? Let us know a little bit more about you and who Natalie is.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So this whole journey towards magnesium, you know, 5 years ago, if you told me, hey, were you going to be completely obsessed with magnesium? I would have said you were crazy. So, but you know, 5 years ago, my life was really, really different. I was dealing with so many issues, everything from constant anxiety, stress. I felt overwhelmed all the time. I had insomnia. All my joints were on fire. Everything hurt. And I just felt miserable all the time. And my family saw that I was miserable all the time. And it was driving everybody around me crazy. So I did what any normal person would do. And I went to my doctor. And she ran a battery of tests. And then she referred me out from one specialist to another specialist to another specialist. And I went on this journey of doctor to doctor and doctor's office. And then eventually, when it was all said and done, all my results came in. My doctor pulled me aside and she said, hey, guess what? There's nothing wrong with you. You are totally normal. And she says, you know what I think is happening? I think you're just getting old. And I thought, what? Is this what my new normal is going to be? Like, I am not okay with that. Like, I'm not okay with feeling like this. So I started researching and I started looking into all the different things out there. And I started seeing functional medicine doctors and I started seeing nutritionists and kind of went through this whole battery of, natural medicine to figure out what was going on with me. And somebody had recommended magnesium. And I thought, you know, I've tried everything else under the sun. Let me give this a go and see what happens. And within, you know, just using magnesium on my skin, I all of a sudden was able to sleep again. I went from sleeping 2 hours a night to sleeping 6 hours a night, which was a huge improvement in my mood. I found that my panic attacks were going away, that I wasn't anxious all the time, and that generally I was just happier and felt energetic and vibrant. And I thought, there's got to be something to this mineral. There's got to be something to this. And I also, one of the things that really hit me was, why didn't my doctors tell me about this? Why didn't I know about this? Why wasn't this showing up on blood work? And why doesn't everybody know about this?
Right.
And that's what jumpstarted my mission. That's what made me like, okay, I need to let people know, you know?
Yeah, no. And you know what? I love that you said that this is just something you just weren't accepting. And a lot of people that we interview and that we, and not even just on our podcast, that people just we speak to on a regular basis have these similar stories where it's like, hey, you know, no, that's not really, I'm not taking that answer for, you know, gospel truth. I don't think that that's just the end all be all to my prognosis. Like, I'm just getting old, or I'm just going to have to deal with my pain, or there's just nothing we can do, or it's all in your head, or all the things that we hear. I love that you said, no, I'm going to go find answers to this. And, you know, that's normally what I've seen, what leads to people helping other people is that they have a battle. They overcome it. That heart of an underdog we've talked about before, name of our show, right? We're discovering that the human spirit, it wants to go after, you know, the solutions, the answer. We love a good mystery, you know, also, you know, kind of funny, but it's true. Like, we got to solve the problem. Like, we're just like, no, I know that this is possible. In my head, I always think, you know, I've seen way more impossible things happen. There's no way I can't find an answer to this. I'm resourceful, right? So that's why I go after these things. And so I love hearing stories from people who not only went after their own solutions, but then created solutions for other people. And that's where the best stuff comes from for society. So I wanted to just dive in just a little bit more to, can you talk a little bit, sorry, to our audience about this whole idea that you were going through all these symptoms and then you went to the doctor. Like, what kind of symptoms are related to magnesium deficiency besides, you know, what you were dealing with? Is there just a huge amount of different symptoms that could mean that you're low on magnesium? How would somebody have any idea that it's a magnesium issue?
Absolutely. So symptoms that are associated with low magnesium include headaches and chronic migraines, insomnia, anxiety, depression, muscle cramps, restless legs, just hormonal imbalance, even high blood pressure, high blood sugar. All of that can be traced back to low magnesium. And it's so interesting because the National Institute of Health says that about 70% of the country is severely deficient in magnesium. And so we're seeing like these symptoms. And if you think of anybody out there, you could think of, well, you know, I know somebody who deals with insomnia. I know somebody who deals with anxiety. Like, these are common symptoms that we're dealing with every single day. There's this amazing, amazing doctor. Her name is Dr. Carolyn Dean. And she wrote this incredible book called The Magnesium Miracle. So if you're ever, you know, curious about magnesium and want to learn everything, that is an incredible resource. But in her book, she says that as much as 85% of doctor's visits can be traced back to low magnesium. So we're seeing this as an epidemic. Like, this is a real, real issue. And there are so many theories as to why this is happening. My theory is that it's not present in our food the way that it used to be 50 or even 100 years ago, simply because our soil practices have changed so much. Our agricultural industry is not what it used to be. And the vitamins and minerals and nutrients that are found in our food are significantly lower as a result. So we're seeing that as absolutely a problem. But then we're also seeing that the standard American diet is just chock full of processed foods and sugar and caffeine and alcohol and all that garbage, which naturally depletes our magnesium levels and is very, very low in nutrients and minerals as well. So that both of those things are happening, and we're not replenishing all the good stuff that we need to function at our absolute best. And then when we go to the doctor, nobody mentions diet. You know, that really should be the number one thing that you address before you address anything else, is diet is everything. And so, like, it's really this interesting cycle that's happening in our society that really needs to be addressed.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. You know, I love that you bring up the nutrition aspect of it, because there's no magic formula, really. There's no magic pill that you can take that's going to cure all these different things. Where we all need to start is that basic good nutrition. And look, on this show, you know, we love our doctors, but just your doctors are human beings. And just like any human being, some are not as good as others, or for whatever reason, they're focused on a particular thing and they're stuck in the, you know, their way of thinking. But there are some great doctors out there that do think outside the box, that do open themselves up and open up their practice to different ways of thinking. So the thing is maybe your doctor has told you, hey, you need to change your nutritional habits. So you go ahead and you switch to a healthier lifestyle, which is great. And one of the things that you pointed out that we all need to remember is that even with the best nutrition, the best quality of vegetables that are out there, vegetables and fruits and all these different things, and let's say that you've switched to that lifestyle and you think, hey, I'm good. This, and this has magnesium in it. I should be getting plenty of magnesium, but you're still having these issues.
Absolutely. Diet is number one.
Yeah. And even though you're starting off a good foot, you might need something extra.
Because of the soil, like you said.
Right. Because of the quality of food that is out there is just not to the level that our body is requiring.
Right.
Right.
Can you talk more about like maybe some solutions that people could be looking for? What have you found to be the foods that are highest in magnesium? What are some, you know, workarounds with that problem, not being able to find foods that are high in magnesium as far as like, you know, where you start is diet. So where would you say somebody would want to start in their diet?
Sure. So I think part of the problem happens to be the fact that everybody's definition of a healthy diet is different. Like we get so many different resources that say this is healthy, you know, keto is healthy, then paleo is healthy, then, you know, like there's so many different diets and what's healthy. You go to the grocery store and you see a box of Fruit Loops and it says made with whole grains and you assume it's healthy. And as we all know, it's just a sugar bomb with artificial dyes, but it can be really confusing. So I always say the number one way to not only increase your magnesium, but all of your nutrients across the board is to eat real food that you make at home. Not coming from a box, not coming from a can or a jar or anything like that, but real food where you take your lean proteins, you take your vegetables, you take your whole grains and you cook them up at home. That's your number one thing you can do. And when you do that, you're going to see that you eat more green leafy vegetables. You're probably eating more nuts and seeds. You're eating more whole grains. And all of those foods are great, great sources of magnesium. In particular, things like chia seeds, pumpkin seeds, all of those really great, healthy, dark leafy vegetables, not iceberg lettuce, but you know, the good stuff.
Yeah, the good
stuff.
All
of those are great sources of magnesium. Absolutely. The other thing we need to think about when we think about magnesium is not only just how much we're getting into our diet, but how much we're expending on a daily basis. So there are certain things that you can do that really, really deplete your magnesium stores. One of which is to drink alcohol, drink caffeine, eat sugar. For every molecule of sugar, you need 54 molecules of magnesium to balance that out. So especially with Halloween coming around the corner, we all have our children. They're going to binge on sugar and you'll notice that their behavior changes. You might notice that they're getting leg cramps the next day. You might notice that they're extraordinarily hyper. And those are all symptoms of low magnesium. So we definitely see that correlation between high sugar and low magnesium.
That is such good information. I had no idea that you needed so much magnesium to balance the sugar. And you said caffeine, of course, and alcohol. But would you say, let me ask you this. When it comes to that's good to know for what we're consuming. But what if somebody's like super healthy and they're like, oh, Natalie, I don't do any of that. But what about the people that are high stressed? You know, what about stress and lifestyle and lack of sleep and things like that? What is that doing to our magnesium levels?
So stress and magnesium have this really interesting relationship. The more stressed you are, the more magnesium you're going to deplete. The more magnesium deplete, the more anxious and stressed you feel. So you've got this vicious cycle. When I was going through my health crisis and dealing with anxiety and panic attacks, I was doing everything you're supposed to do, eating the organic diet. I was exercising daily. I had no toxins in my house. You know, I made all my food from scratch. But I think that one missing puzzle for me was that stress aspect, because I was living, I'm a type A person, super high energy, and I was living a really high stress lifestyle. So sometimes we could be doing all the right things, and that one little neglect part that we neglect can really come back and bite us.
Wow, you just nailed me. Like, that's literally me. You just described me. Like, I'm making whole foods. I'm, you know, exercising every day. We just removed all of the toxins from our house, so we're really excited about that. All those things. Yet I am like, go, go, go. You know, I'm sitting here going, well, obviously, like, if I don't address, you know, if I don't go out and try to figure out if it's a magnesium issue, because I can see myself as just being such a high, I'm like a type A, ambitious, high energy, you know, I just like eat and live stress, you know, just based on that stress isn't always negative. Mm-hmm. Like, as far as it could be stress, just, you know, the stress we put on ourselves based on just being ambitious or just, you know, achieving or, you know, just getting a lot done or whatever.
Yeah. You mentioned how stress is such a vicious cycle, and we've talked about this in the past before, but it really is, because isn't it weird? Well, it's not so weird, but when we are stressed, we go for those exact things that also continue to deplete our magnesium.
Yeah.
We go for the sugary snacks, right?
Caffeine.
We drink the coffee because we need to stay awake, right? We need to meet that deadline. We need to drink that coffee, more coffee, more coffee. And then, of course, if we're really stressed, what do we need to do to relax ourselves? Alcohol.
Yeah.
So it's no wonder in our culture today, that there's a high amount of people living with low magnesium levels. It's crazy, but really we're trying to break that cycle.
Yeah.
You know, just what you were saying about, you know, really setting yourself up to win, you have to eat a good balanced diet, nutritional diet, right? But what we're hearing, we also need some sort of stress management.
Absolutely. That right? is the key right there. That is the key. And the science behind it is the balance between being in the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system. So our sympathetic nervous system is like, go, 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 you know, fight or flight, gotta go, gotta go, gotta go, which is important. We need that, you know, but we get stuck there. And I think that's kind of like what you were saying, is that, you know, you're doing all the great stuff and we've got good stress and bad stuff, but you still feel like you got to keep going. We kind of get like stuck in that sympathetic nervous system kind of mentality. Yeah. And our society does us no good, because, you know, we live in a society that, oh, you took a vacation day. Like, oh, that's terrible. Like, you know, we don't have enough time for rest. You know, people brag about the fact that, oh, I only need 4 hours of sleep to survive. No, you need 8 hours. You can function on 4, you know, But, you know, so we're really stuck on this, the sympathetic nervous system. When you take magnesium, it literally activates the parasympathetic nervous system. And it tells your body, hey, let's relax. It's time to calm down. We need to chill out, which is why it's so effective at combating anxiety. And it's so effective at combating insomnia, because it's literally telling your brain and your body to chill out. It also lowers cortisol levels. So there's really incredible research. I think it was in 2017 that they did this research study, and they measured the cortisol levels in the participants and then gave them magnesium, and their cortisol levels dramatically went down. And cortisol is our stress hormone. So the more we can bring that down, the better we feel.
Absolutely. I have so many questions. This is so amazing. I'm just so intrigued by this, because there's this, I mean, look, the things that you're saying, like improving your diet and all the stress management, this is all good for everything that we're dealing with. I mean, this is good for heart disease, diabetes, you know, autoimmune. This is good for, you know, all obesity. Okay. Everything we're saying, it leads to better health overall, holistic health. But when you're pinpointing this one thing that people just are missing, it really is. I mean, that could be a reason enough to be doing all those things, which then gives you all of these added benefits. When you're talking to people about rebalancing their magnesium, you know, you make me want to take a magnesium bath right now. I'm just like, that sounds amazing. So I'm like, but I don't know what am I supposed to do? So I've taken magnesium before. I can never figure out what magnesium to take. I don't know which ones do what. I don't know how much to take. Is it absorbable? I don't know. I'm just like lost. So can you start breaking down for us and our audience kind of, you know, what is it? Where do we start? How do we get good magnesium? What do we use? And what led you to the products that you produce?
Absolutely. So your best form, of course, is diet. That's always the number one. We always start with diet. And just to kind of drive that home, please realize that magnesium will do nothing for your health if you're still, you know, eating pizza every night and French fries and drinking a six pack of beer. Like, you can't expect to live that kind of lifestyle and then take a magnesium pill and everything's going to be better. So your first line of defense, always, always, always diet and lifestyle. But to make up for those gaps that you might be missing, magnesium is wonderful. So there's several different types. And this is where people tend to get really overwhelmed. And they're like, I tried magnesium. It didn't work. I didn't feel anything. It tends to kind of boil down to the different type of magnesium you're taking. So I'll kind of briefly go over them. Magnesium threonate. Threonate has been really popular in the market because there's some studies showing that it can pass the blood-brain barrier. I will say it's the most expensive form of magnesium on the market. And the studies are showing that it's very good for your brain. So we're talking dementia, mood, memory, mental fatigue, that kind of thing. So if that's where you're seeing most of your problems, then that's going to be a good one to go for. The next one is citrate, and citrate you're going to see in most health food stores. It's a lot of like brands will use citrate. Citrate is good. It can be very good for anxiety and stress, but it can be very hard on the digestive system. So a lot of people will get, you know, stomach upset, loose stools, that kind of thing from taking it. So if you have a sensitive stomach, you might want to avoid citrate. Okay. Glycinate is one of the best absorbed forms of magnesium. It's particularly good for sleep and can really, really calm you down. So glycinate, I like to take that right before bedtime because it'll just give me the best night's sleep. Malate is probably one of my favorites just because it's incredible for fatigue. So if you are the kind of person that hits that like 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock afternoon slump, and you don't want to take a cup of coffee because it'll give you the jitters, malate is incredible. It gives you a great energy boost. There's no crash associated with it. And it's also particularly good for muscle issues. So if you're dealing with fibromyalgia, arthritis, any kind of pain, malate is definitely a good one. The other two that are very, very popular, and you're going to find them in lots of supplements, are carbonate and oxide. And both of those two are very poorly absorbed. They are a cheap filler that people use in multivitamins, and they're not going to raise your magnesium levels in a significant way. So stay away from those two. And then what you were saying earlier, magnesium baths, Epsom salt is magnesium sulfate. Epsom salt is awesome. Like, I recommend taking 2 to 3 times a week, take an Epsom salt bath. And if you don't have time for that, at least soak your feet in Epsom salt, which gives you similar benefits, but you don't have to sit, you know, in the bathtub for 20 minutes. So it's great to do while you're working, you know, keep a basin underneath your desk or if you're watching TV or reading. My magical, you know, recipe for that is 2 cups of Epsom salt, 1 cup of baking soda. Baking soda, the bicarbonate, is a cofactor for the magnesium and will actually usher it into your cells a little bit faster. And soak for at least 20 minutes. So that's just a quick, and Epsom salt, you can find it. I mean, even the dollar store sells it. So it's a wonderful, cheap, quick way of getting your magnesium levels up. And then the last one is the one that's affected me the most, which is magnesium chloride. And magnesium chloride goes right on your skin. It's usually found in an oil, a spray, or a cream. And it is incredible. There was actually a 2016 or 2017 study done on magnesium chloride showing that participants were able to up their levels of magnesium in about 12 weeks using magnesium chloride on their skin, wow, which typically will take anywhere from 6 to 12 months if you were to take an oral supplement. So we're seeing that it absorbs way faster, brings your levels up incredibly quickly, and you don't have the side effects that you sometimes have with oral supplements that'll give you like digestive upset and loose stools and that kind of thing.
Okay, first of all, I just want to take a second, because that was an amazing amount of information. Like, I am so glad I have this on record because we have so many different varied issues in our family, and a lot of people do, you know, it's not like you have one medical issue in your family. Everyone's different. Everyone has something that they're different they're dealing with. And I love that this is just one of those things that deals with, you know, I'm sure that magnesium deficiency is related to adrenal fatigue as well.
Yes. Oh my goodness. Yes. Adrenal fatigue. Wow. Magnesium is one of the most incredible supplements for adrenal fatigue. Because as you know, with adrenal fatigue, your cortisol levels are all over the place. They're spiking in the middle of the night when you should be sleeping, and then they're crashing in the middle of the afternoon when you should be awake. Right. So yeah. The beautiful thing of magnesium is it just kind of mellows you out when you need to be mellow and kind of retrains that whole HPA axis to kind of work in the way it's supposed to.
Okay.
Great.
So when you were going after this magnesium solution, you're like, okay, like this is what I need to do. You said that your doctor didn't tell you this. Can you go rewind and tell us where you came to the conclusion that you did have low magnesium and how you discovered that and kind of what led you to be making these amazing products that we're going to talk about in a minute?
Absolutely. So the crazy thing is my doctor did a magnesium test. They did a serum test. You know, it's part of your panel. You get your vitamin D checked and your thyroid and this, that, and the other thing. And magnesium was on the test. My magnesium was fine. She said it was fine. I looked at the blood work. It was within that little range that they have on there. Later down the road, when I went kind of dove down into research, I discovered that only 1% of your magnesium is stored in your blood. So if we're only looking at 1% of what's going on in the body, it's not telling us what's really happening. About 60% is stored in your bones and 40% in your muscles. So if we're looking at, you know, in order to find out what's going on, we can't look at the blood. And unfortunately, the serum test is what doctors typically will give you, and it's what insurance will typically cover. Mm-hmm. So there are better options out there for testing. My personal favorite is the HTMA test. It's the hair tissue mineral analysis, I believe is what it stands for. And that is like you cut a little piece of your hair, you send it in, and not only does it tell you what's going on with the minerals in your body, it'll also tell you what kind of heavy metals are going on. Do you have aluminum or mercury buildup, that kind of thing, because it can all be seen in your hair, which is an amazing feat of science.
Yeah, I was going to say, how do you mail something in to a test if it's not blood? So that's really, really good to know. Hey, for our listeners, I just brought up this link for Even Better Now is the website that Natalie used to do her analysis. I'm going to go ahead and drop this into the description so you'll have just click and go links. But I just wanted to bring this up so you can kind of see that there are specific tests to be doing. And Natalie, how much does this cost when you go do these tests?
I did it probably a few years ago and it was $85. I think the price might be around 100 now. But for the information that you get from it, it really is a really great panel to do. I make no money from them. I'm not associated with them at all. It's just, that's what I use. And I thought it was very enlightening.
So you said with the amount of information that you get, so it's not just magnesium that they measure.
Yeah, it measures calcium. It measures so much in that one panel. Definitely worthwhile.
And is this something that is for all ages? Do you feel like this, all of these treatments, the magnesium, like that you provide, the testing, is this all for kids and both for adults and kids?
Absolutely. That's one of the number one questions I get is, I think my kid is magnesium deficient. Will it help them? And absolutely, because children need magnesium too. They're growing at a rapid rate. They're so active. They're sweating out their electrolytes and they're involved in sports. And we think about it, like I live in Florida where it's hot year round. They sweat all day long. You send them out in the yard to play for an hour, they come back dripping wet and we sweat out our magnesium. So often as parents, we give our kids, you know, Gatorade or an electrolyte drink, but those electrolyte drinks just have potassium and sodium. They're missing magnesium. So we're only replacing part of the electrolytes. We're missing that one key. So that's why we so often see children dealing with hyperactivity. We see them dealing with, you know, inability to sleep or sit still or focus. There's some really, really amazing research. I want to say it was 2005, maybe 2006, that they did research on children with ADHD and found that their magnesium levels were chronically low. And when they brought those levels up, they saw the symptoms of ADHD decrease dramatically. So there's definitely some behavior issues associated with low magnesium that need to be researched more thoroughly.
Yeah. Wow. This is such incredible information. I just am so excited that you're on our show because I mean, this is just answers that I have. I can already think of people in my mind that have just been struggling with things. You know, as you know, we're health coaches and this is the kind of information we're always looking for. It's just like constantly learning about more and more things.
It's funny as you're talking, I'm just going through all my clients that are suffering from this, suffering from that. Yeah. And
we've already addressed with nutrition, fitness and everything, but this one key point, and even our daughter, really, I was thinking about too. I mean, there's just so many things that this could mean. because of specific health issues. And so I'm just so grateful for your research. I'm grateful for your ability, your willingness and ability to go out and really take this on. Cause I know that it's been a total labor of love, as you described it, for, bringing this product to market. So can you talk about your products and what they do and why you've made them creams and all of the amazing things that you're doing?
Sure. So when I first started using magnesium, I would use magnesium chloride spray, and it's just pure magnesium chloride. Chloride is salt. So when you spray that on your skin, it worked incredibly, but it left my skin chalky and dry and itchy and irritated. And then I made the mistake of spraying it on my children, and they would scream like banshees because it would irritate their skin. And I thought there's got to be a better way, which kind of brought me into like a deep dive into what can we do to make this more palatable. And there are a bunch of magnesium creams on the market where they've taken the chloride and mixed it with creams, but they're greasy and heavy, and they don't feel good on the skin. And living in Florida, nobody wants to wear greasy, heavy lotions. No. You know, when you sit down on a chair and you get up and you leave that grease imprint on the chair, it's just not pleasant, you know? So I wanted to find something that I would look forward to using that felt a little bit more luxurious, that had more than just magnesium in it. Because at the time, I was also using amazing adaptogenic herbs. I use essential oils. I'm a certified clinical aromatherapist. So I'm a big believer in the power of things like oils and herbs. And so there was nothing out there. And I thought, well, I can figure this out. So fast forward about a year and a half working with manufacturers and chemists from all over the world to create a product that had a ton of magnesium in it, but also felt really good on your skin. And we finally hammered it down about a year ago, and we've been going ever since. We created three formulas. One formula is specifically made for pain. So it's not only got the magnesium, but it's also got arnica and comfrey and ginger and white willow bark and peppermint and birch and all these beautiful oils that really support inflammation coming down and pain reduction. And then we also created one that's called Rest Cream, and that one is incredible for sleep, made with passion flower and chamomile and lavender. And then our last one, which is our definitely one of our most popular products, is our Tranquility Cream. And that one is for stress and anxiety with ashwagandha and rhodiola root and tulsi. Just really good herbs that kind of help calm your body down as well.
I feel like I just had a massage. Listening to you. Wait, seriously. And I remember when we had spoken before, it was just like, oh, I have got to get all of this. And, you know, of course, I haven't. Why? Why haven't I? Because I've been so stressed and busy and ambitious. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. So, but you've reminded me once again. This is like, could you just call me once a week and remind me about what I need to do? About my stress? Just follow me around and just, hey, Jessica, chill. But I absolutely, because here's the thing, even if you're not experiencing all of those things, like you're not having insomnia, you're not having all of, you know, depression and, oh, I don't have anxiety issues, but maybe you're just stressed and you're not getting enough sleep and you're really high energy, you know, you're high energy, you're high, go, go, go. And you're just feeling kind of the beginning stages of burnout. And you're just like, how do I relax? I don't have time to sit in a bath. This is the kind of thing where it's like, you know, maybe order the test, maybe figure out if that's part of your issue. Maybe you're doing all the things, but you just can't quite get that magnesium into your system the way that you could be if you were just directly targeting that. And so this is an easy, simple way to be able to get that magnesium restored in your body. I mean, I'm headed right in that direction now. I'm going to go do it because I'm seeing that in myself. You know, I mean, it feels like when you're doing all the right things, it's like, gosh, maybe I just am getting old. Maybe I just am, you know, because you're thinking there's no way that I'm missing another thing, but it's true. These days it's just not present in all of the many, you know, nature-based things that we're, you know, doing because of the way that society is now. We've just really taken the minerals and vitamins out of everything.
Yeah. You know, go ahead.
I was going to say, you know, not only just our diet, but I mean, we live it with around the clock media where anytime you turn on the TV, there's shootings, there's this, there's that. It's just so much scary stuff that our body is almost constantly responding to stress. It's wild.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. I guess, you know, you don't think about that kind of thing. It's like, that's why people take social media fast and stop watching the news.
Yeah. maybe someone really did go and unplug Facebook and social media the other day.
Everyone needs a break.
We all need a break.
Yeah.
anyway, no, but one of the things that you had pointed out from the you know, the very beginning, and, you know, you said it again, the doctors and society tell us, well, we all know that we're getting old. Yeah. And what getting old equates to is this. It equates to muscle loss. It equates to muscle pain, illness, all these things. You're going to get old, and this is what's going to happen to you. It's just a fact. Yes, we're all going to get old, but the facts aren't what the perceived facts aren't true, that we don't have to live with chronic pain. We don't have to live in a body that is necessarily just, you know, breaking down. We concede. We tend to just say, well, we haven't found the answers. We're trying to do all the right things. We're eating right. Maybe we're even exercising. But I still have this pain. I still feel tired. I'm still stressed. Still. So maybe it's just the fact that I'm getting old, and we go ahead and concede. And one of the things I love about you is that you're one of those that say, no, there has to be an answer here. I'm not willing to concede to that. I have a whole life I want to live. I want to be able to enjoy my life. The thing is I hear people say all the time, I just want to be able to live my life and eat what I want to eat. And they equate to living their life, a full life, to what they eat and put in their body. And I'm going to tell you right now, if you're just eating whatever and putting junk in your body, you're not living a full life.
Yeah.
Period.
Absolutely.
There's a whole life without pain, chronic pain and anxiety, and just all these terrible things are happening to us if we would just get our nutrition straight, start with that, and then look at things like our magnesium levels and try products like yours, and a whole world could be opened up to you. Things that you thought were gone, things that you thought, well, this is how my life is, that you could just get rid of and live a life without,
you know, how many times
without pain
people have been like, the whole time, I wish I would have just known about that. I wish I would have done that. I wish I put out a question the other day on social media. What's the number one thing you know, that changed your life, was a game changer, that you wish you would have done much sooner? And there's so many things on there. People, I mean, I was a huge amount of response, because people are just, you know, of course they want to share the heck out of that. And a lot of people are sharing things that are all like nutrition based. They're like, I wish I would have changed my nutrition sooner. I wish I would have, you know, of course, all of the risk taking, you know, is on there too. I wish I would have sooner, you know, went after my degree or whatever. But there's so much health related stuff on there. It's like, people really want this. They really want answers. They really want solutions. Yeah. But we're so caught up in the cycle of living in we call it the familiar zone, because it's not even the comfort zone anymore, because it's not comfortable. It's painful, but it's familiar. So we just think it's normal. And that was the last thing I wanted to say too, is, you know, remember, when doctors are telling you that you're normal, that just means you're in the range of what they have seen in everyone else. That doesn't mean, and that you aren't in a dangerous position, basically. Mm-hmm. Like, you're not, they're trying to keep you from life and death, right? Mm-hmm. So when they say you're in normal range, that just means you're average. And that there's no danger imminent, basically. It doesn't mean that you're healthy. It doesn't mean that you're thriving. It doesn't mean that the things are going to get better. It doesn't mean that there's a solution. It just means, well, no danger. You know, you can go home and figure it out on your own now.
Yeah, basically. I think the thing that I learned so much from this whole experience was that I get to define what's normal, not the doctor. I get to say, it's not normal for me to be tired. It's not normal for me to sleep 2 hours a night. Even though the doctor said, well, your body is normal. No, it's not my normal. And I get to decide what that is. And I definitely encourage other people, you are in control of your health. Yes, your doctor is a wonderful resource and can really, really help you along on that journey. But you are ultimately responsible for how you feel. So don't stop. Keep going. I always say that this whole experience was a divine tap on the shoulder from God saying, hey, there's something going on. You need to wake up and you need to address this. And so I'm grateful for it. I'm grateful for everything that I went through, because it brought me to where I am now. And to kind of address what you were saying when it comes to being told that you're, oh, it's just you getting older. I look at countries from all around the world, especially the blue line areas where people live well past 100 regularly. And they're not, when they talk about them living past 100, it's not that, oh, they're alive past 100. No, they're living past 100. Yes. They're walking every day. They're working. They're taking care of their grandchildren. They're loving their life. And that's how I want to age. That's how I have chosen. That's what I chose to be my normal. And that's what I'm working hard to achieve. And I hope that that inspires somebody out there to choose what their normal is going to be.
That's great.
I love that. I love. That's what you brought up because it's true. What's normal for us could be normal, not normal somewhere else. And I just, yeah, I love that. Can you tell everybody where they can get a hold of you? Because I want to just like, I want to go to the top of the mountain and decree that everyone needs to run over to Natalie's website right now and get some of this, this amazing magnesium, products that you provide because they're just, I actually just want to see everybody just get healthy and see what happens. And I'm going to recommend this to my clients. And I'm just very excited right now. I can't even talk.
Awesome. Awesome. Yes. So I can be found across all social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Pinterest, all of it at berootedin. And our website is berootedin.com. And I also have an incredible resource for you because I know I kind of went through all the different types of magnesium and all the symptoms. I went through that really quickly. So if you want to kind of go back and see all the research that I have and just in an easy to read, easy to absorb format, I've got an incredible resource. If you go to berootedin.com/magnesium, there is a free ebook. It's 25 pages long and it goes through everything you've ever wondered about magnesium, how it affects different conditions like diabetes and cholesterol and hormones, all that good stuff is listed in there.
Oh, thank you so much.
Great.
And that's perfect because it's like, yeah, everyone's thinking, oh man, I'm going to go to berootedin.com and I'm going to be completely overwhelmed by all the magnesium information. But actually, Natalie's got you guys. She has a guide. It's only 25 pages and it's everything you've ever wanted to know about magnesium for dummies, basically. And for people like me who are like, I cannot get down with all the science all at once. But you know what? It's going to be okay, you guys. I really highly encourage you to go over to her website. Check out that free guide at berootedin.com/magnesium and download that because it's going to take you through, how to get that test done, where to go look for, what you need. And of course, she has her amazing products there as well. So if you have any questions, make sure to reach out to Natalie. We thank you so much for being on our show today because this is going to improve lives. You are improving lives. You are impacting people for the better, greater good. And it was a divine tap on the shoulder. It wasn't just for you. Obviously, God's using you in people's lives on a greater level, for higher impact. And I just love that you're giving God the glory for that, that you are recognizing that's what your journey is and that you're just really embracing the calling that has been put on you and in living your best life, actually. And I think that's probably one of the biggest rewards in this is that he's given you your best life because you're doing the work that he's giving you to help others live their best life. And that's really what it's all about is impacting lives, right? Yes. So absolutely. We thank you so much for coming.
Well, thank you so much for having me on. And thank you so much for what you guys are doing to spread the message of health and wellness and just vibrant living. I think it's amazing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hey, it's people like you on our show that really continue to inspire me to keep going and to always be looking for the next solution around the corner. Because even when you think you know all the solutions, there's always something else that God has. There's always something else that he's given someone else. And it could possibly solve an issue that, it's not medication or it's not, those poisonous things we put in our bodies. It's the things that have already been provided for us through his creation. So I just absolutely love this.
Yes. Again, thank you so much for coming. We really, really appreciate it. I know our audience just going to love this. So make sure if you didn't write down that website, we'll have all the links in the description, but make sure you go ahead and check out that website and get yourself some of these products.
Absolutely. Hey, have a great rest of your day, Natalie, and we will see you next time we chat.
Take care.
Bye. Thanks. Bye. Wow. I can't talk.
Yeah.
That's so amazing.
Yeah. My brain is just spinning right now because there's so many people that I'm thinking, wow, we could help. And there's so many other sufferers out there, I think, that are suffering from this low magnesium levels. And even myself, you know, I'm thinking of, you know, the beginning of my heart disease, you know, many, many years ago, how there's a great possibility that, you know, I started this heart disease journey because of my magnesium levels being low. Because like she said, in a lot of our day-to-day foods, you know, it's very low in magnesium, and we may be living our life for many, many years this way. And it's led us to other types of diseases and conditions.
And, you know, we were talking about, I wanted to touch on, remember, we were talking about the cortisol levels, that she said reduce cortisol levels. And hello, we all know that cortisol plays a huge role in a lot of, you know, issues with heart disease in particular, but also other issues. You know, cortisol really attacks our body when we are constantly in it. Adrenal fatigue, we talked about. Man, if you find yourself just constantly just kind of overworked, overstressed, things like that, you might have something like adrenal fatigue.
And the stress, what does stress lead to? High blood pressure. If you could control that stress and control your high blood pressure just through some magnesium supplements, you know, we need all the help we could get naturally.
Yes.
You know, we all kind of lean to, you know, those pills that the doctors give us, all those medications. Well, you know, here you'll know that we tend to lean more to the natural products, natural foods, or natural products that we, that will help us get to those goals, get to feeling better, easier and better and more fulfilling. They're safer for us, right?
Less side effects. Well, that's the thing. Not just safer and less side effects, but actually leaning into and leading to better health overall. Like we said, you know, when you're doing things like addressing low magnesium levels, you're doing things like improving your diet, exercise, and all of that, and lowering your stress, which then leads to other health improvements. I mean, it all rolls together. When you're taking a medication, it only is addressing the one thing. It is not addressing anything else. It doesn't lead into any other improvements in your body that you may or may not know you have. And it gives you side effects, maybe even worsening those other parts of your health that you know what I'm saying? So it's really overall, when you're talking about using more natural methods, it's not just all about, you know, natural herb. Sometimes it's literally restoring your body to the state it needs to fully function and operate in a healthy way to be able to have the energy to do the things we're called to do here on earth. You know, it's like, it's really about restoration. And I think that's what's so amazing about what she's doing is she's not giving you some sort of magic herb. She's like, she said, I love that she said this. This is not going to even help you. You won't even notice a difference if you're still filling your body with toxins.
Yeah.
You have to be doing the things in your life that make sense. And then this can fill in the gaps. This can give you the restoration of the magnesium levels if you were depleted or things like that.
What I loved about Natalie is that you saw her true heart. She gave us a tremendous amount of value without even plugging her product, right?
Yeah.
And what I love is, you know, we were talking about stress and some of the things you can do on your own. Even like, I didn't even think about an Epsom salt bath.
Yeah.
You know, I swear we're going to buy her products, but the next time I see you all high stress, I'm going to dunk you in this Epsom salt bath. And then we're just going to just douse you with this cream.
Yeah. And I'll take it.
Calm down.
You need to, I love how she's like, magnesium's like, you need to chill. And I'm like, well, that's what I'm saying to myself a lot. So I'm down with magnesium. You know what I'm saying? I'm in agreement. So I just think this is such a great episode. I'm so excited that we get to release this to you guys. And so let us know in the comments, you know, what this has done for you today. What did you learn today? What was the takeaway that you have now that you can go and apply? I'm telling you, I want to go get that test to see where my body's really at. I want to go see if I'm really, you know, I want you to get the magnesium test.
Yeah, because it may not just be magnesium. It may be all these other things. And what I think is great is that test, you know, it shows all these other factors that you may not be looking at or your doctor may not be looking at.
Right.
And this is something that you can show them, take those tests to your doctor and say, hey, I have this and this symptom. And this is a test I took recently, not a blood test, and just show them the science. And hopefully you have a doctor that's open to that and will help you down this journey.
Absolutely. And that's a good point. Make sure you're talking to your doctor about, you know, messing around with your medications or supplements or things like that, because you just never know and you don't want to get yourself into a sticky situation. But we just absolutely love this today. We thank you for joining us. As you know, we'll have all these links, like we keep saying, in the description, so you don't have to look around for them. We've got your back. And, you know, look, another thing, if you guys want to work with us, if you're thinking, hey, I have more than just this going on, guys. I don't even know where I'm going with my nutrition. I don't know. You guys were talking about how to switch your nutrition. I don't know how to do that. I don't know how to work out every day, or I've never been in a gym or whatever. This is what we help people with. This is what we do. So if you want to look further into working with us so that we can help you get on the right track, we can help you get a plan together. And we, you know, maybe you want to just have somewhere to track everything on our app. You know, maybe it's just that, and having somebody hold your hand along the way. That's what we're here to do. So if you want to look into working with us, make sure you email us at support@javiandjessicamadrigal.com, and we will respond to you and talk about the options that you have in front of you so that you can get on the right track for better health for your life.
Absolutely. Hey guys, we're going to let you go, but I hope you guys got some value today. Wow, today was just chock filled with lots and lots of information. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give us that thumbs up, all right? And make sure you're hitting that that notification bell so you are notified when we post new content.
That's right. Hey, have a great week, and we'll see you next time. God bless. Bye.